Dan, do you think that VR really is the next big thing for branded content, or is it still too much in its infancy to actually be a viable, monetizable business opportunity for your clients?
I think it's one of the big things, and I think the, as Tarek said, the big issue at the moment is that not enough people have the devices in their hands, and also not enough stuff is being produced, which is really great. I don't think so. We haven't had the Chewbacca mask woman moment for virtual reality yet, and we haven't had the, you know, the dad doing a Skype interview with the kids bursting in moment, and so there's been nothing really. There's a lot of stuff in virtual reality which is pretty good, and we share around, and we like watching, and we like taking part in, but there's been nothing that, you know, 50 of your friends in a day have been posting up on Facebook saying you have to have this. And I think that's why a lot of the VR things we've seen so far that have been very good have been installations, essentially, where people go to a place and they take part in it.
As publishers, the challenge I think that we have in our discussions with clients is how do you manage the reach and scale conversation at a media level? So, you know, we have done some quite good stuff in this area, but actually our editorial colleagues have kind of led the way as well in terms of actually bringing VR into their news gathering operation. I think for us, it's, you know, the challenge that clients are always talking to us about is how many, you know, what is going to be our engagement and reach. So what we've tried to do, I think, on the project that we've worked on is create content for headsets, so you have that immersive experience, but then also create 360 environments for desktop and mobile experiences, which hopefully therefore will give you the reach that and return that clients are after. So I think that there's definitely the interest there. I think for us, we were lucky that the client that we were working with understood the cost, the time that it will take to produce this, because it's, you're not going to do this in 2, 3, 4 weeks. This is, you know, 3 or 4 month piece of work. I think if you can get all of those things, you know, aligned with a client, then I think you can do some good stuff. But just to pick up, I think, on what, you know, what Dan was saying as well, I think we've all seen in the physical environment where it's really, really powerful, where you have events or sponsorships, or so people have lag time, they can go in and experience it. We had, you know, people, as you know, at South By, and there was a lot of people, you know, talking about VR and different products and tools that are now kind of displaying it. And I think that's where it has been very, very effective. But of course, again, in our world, a lot of our clients aren't in that space, so we need to try and find different solutions.
You know, I think for travel and tourism is quite interesting, because one of the things you're looking for when you're planning a holiday is a sense of space and environment, and that's what VR can definitely do, given its sort of spatial technology. Where it becomes limited, I think, and interestingly, you know, I know we're going to talk about it, we did something for Jaguar, but and Jaguar have actually produced VR to give people a sort of an up-close experience of drive of their cars. But what VR definitely can't do is recreate the amazing feeling of driving a Jaguar. So I think it's got limitations in terms of how brands can use it to give experience of their product. And I think for certain categories it works really well. I think it's very difficult for food brands, for example, because there's no sense of smell and taste. And, you know, getting a bit up closer to a plate of pasta is not really any different to sort of seeing it in a magazine, right? So for us, there needs to be some sort of element of transporting you somewhere. And either physically to take you to a place that you might not get to experience right away, or emotionally to take you inside someone's mind to create some sort of more cognitive experience. So,
from a technology perspective, what we don't like right now in the VR, that we're using everything from 2D world. So we're putting multiple cameras together to create a 360. It's not yet a VR camera. In the meaning, we're using the same post-production tools. Even when we stream, we're using a 4K platform to stream. And I don't think this is the way to move forward. We did that because we need to deliver now, because the headsets, they want content. But I don't think this is next year or the year after. So it's an evolution, and it's a hand-in-hand relationship.